Hi everyone. Today's lesson, Sale of Goods Act 1930. Topic chosen is distinction between sale and agreement to sell. Let's see one by one. First one, executed contract in the case of sale. In the case of agreement to sell, it is an executory contract. What's the meaning? Executed means already the transaction is over. All the essential elements of a contract of sale is completed. But in the case of agreement to sell, it is yet to be completed. So it's an executory contract. Second one, existing goods in the case of agreement to sell, future goods. So the goods must be present, it should be available, it should be in existence. In the case of agreement, it is yet to be procured, yet to be manufactured. So it's a future goods. Third one, deliverable stage. Since it is in existence, it is readily available for delivery. Here, not at deliverable stage, but is yet to be manufactured. Fourth one, ownership and possession process. In the case of sale, since all the essential elements are present, the goods are in existence and it is in a deliverable stage, so it can be transferred immediately. So both the ownership and possession can be easily transferred. But in the case of agreement to sell, only the possession is transferred and the ownership will be transferred only after the completion of the contract. Fifth one, risk of loss with the buyer and here risk of loss with the seller. Since it is an executed contract, the goods are in possession of the buyer. If anything happens to the goods due to fire or theft, in that case, the buyer is responsible for the loss. Just contrary, in that case, only the seller is responsible since the possession is not yet transferred. Sixth one, immediate transfer here, future date transfer. Since the goods are not at deliverable stage, so here it is deliverable stage, immediate transfer can be taken place. Here, not at deliverable stage, only at that time, the goods is already, so it's a future date transfer. Next one, right of resale with the buyer. In the case of sale, only the buyer has got the right to resell the goods. Because the possession as well as the ownership lies with the buyer. In the case of agreement to sell, the right of resale with the seller only, because the possession is not yet transferred, ownership is not yet transferred. Next one, just in ram. Just in ram means right against the whole world. But in the case of agreement to sell, just in personam, right against the person only. So action can be taken only against the person only. Next one, subject to tax here, no tax till ownership passes. Since the transaction is completed, consideration is received, possession is transferred, ownership is transferred, so tax can be levied easily. Here tax cannot be levied since the ownership is not yet been transferred. Next, 10th one, when buyer failed to pay, what the seller can do? He can sue for price and not for the damages. Just contrary, when buyer fails to pay, the seller can sue for damages, not price. 11th one, seller is insolvent. When the seller becomes insolvent, what's the position of the buyer? The buyer can recover the goods from the official receiver. Official receiver means a central government officer appointed through court. Since the seller is declared as insolvent. Just contrary, when the seller is insolvent and the buyer paid the money can claim rateable dividend from the officer, that is official receiver. In the last case, okay, difference, 12th one, when buyer is insolvent, what would be the position of the seller? The buyer, however, should deliver the goods to the official receiver. But whereas in the case of agreement to sell, when the buyer is insolvent, what's the position of the seller? The seller need not deliver the goods since the transaction is not yet completed. Money has not been paid, ownership has not been transferred. So the seller need not deliver the goods. So these are the 12 differences between the sale and agreement to sell. So this is very useful for the student's point of view with regard to all exams, BCom or ACA, ACS and other professional course exams. Thank you so much for watching this video.